100,000. The top men are doing 100,000 up to world champion, probably just grosses half a million.
Bob Armstrong's a wrestler who won't argue about the money, but he says it doesn't come easily and that his job is for real.
Well, if it was fakey, I'd still have all my real teeth. I wouldn't have the bumps and bruises. I wouldn't have the knots. Whenever they take an x-ray of my chest, they always say, "My God, what kind of an accident were you in?" Because most of my ribs were broken in the rear, and that's from taking those falls on your back. Anytime I'm thrown down, I try to hit on my back. When you're going down, you got the only way to go is down. There's no way to fake stopping. You know, you can't stop this far from the mat and settle in. You fall to the mat. And believe you me, it doesn't feel good. It takes your breath. Basically, when you hit that mat, it's nothing but gristle and bone. It hits that mat, you got no protection. But it is exciting, and I guess the money makes it worthwhile.
Bob's son, Brad, is also in the business, despite his father's advice to stay out. Now the pair work out together before matches.
I've been going to the matches since I was little, and all my life I'd sworn no way I'll ever get into that, you know. And then friends would come to the house, fellow wrestlers of dad's, and I'd wrestle around with them, and they'd show me moves, and I got, you know, more interested, and we worked out, wrestled in the ring a couple of times, and it gets in your blood, and it's like Dad was saying, you just can't, I don't know, it's not like no other job, you know, it gets in your blood and you gotta do it. I love it.
At age 18, Brad is the youngest pro wrestler ever to hold the junior heavyweight title, a title he's defending tonight and one that can change hands at any time. But a lost title means lost income, so Brad tries to think positive.
I try not to think about losing that much, you know. I go out there to win, and if you think that there's a doubt, geez, I might lose, then you might, really. And I try not to think about that, you know. If you think you can, maybe you can.
Brad wins, although things look rather intense in the ring at times. But if you're not convinced what you're seeing is real, just ask Brad's opponent, former policeman Jerry Stubbs.
A lot of people say we're fake, we're phony. A lot of say, well, if they call the wrestling business phony, they're really calling me phony. And when I get out there, I don't consider myself phony because everything I do is real. And they say, well, you didn't hit him. When I hit him, you'll know it, and he'll know it too.
Believe it or not, there are rules in pro wrestling. For instance, a wrestler may be disqualified for such things as eye gouging, hair pulling, hitting an opponent with a fist, or throwing him over the ropes. But of course, there are exceptions, so the rules may be bent a bit.
They will allow the rules to be somewhat flexible because naturally, when people are paying money to go through a turnstile, whether it be wrestling, baseball, football, or basketball, you best give them what they're paying to see or they're not going to come back.
Style isn't the only thing that sets pro wrestling apart from the sports pack.
I enjoy it, but the people is one thing other than the wrestlers who I come to watch. Because once it gets boring in the ring, you always look out in the crowd and watch them cuss somebody else out, you know, and tell them what to do and all this. They remind me of a bunch of circus people getting around in one big group and watching somebody else do something.
I like it because, I don't know, you can come down here and let everything go, you know what it's about. I don't know.
A lot of action to it, it's nice. If it wasn't for the wrestlers out here the way they do it, people wouldn't come.
I like to watch the wrestlers and the whole show. It's exciting. I like watching. I like the bad guys. I like to see how they work in the ring and all.
Even the most ardent fans, however, don't always believe pro wrestling is real, and many of them have it down to a science of percentages.
I say 80% is fake and 20% is real because you can't get three men on each side and fake out a whole match that lasts an hour. You can't fake that out. It'll take too long of a time. Somebody's gonna get hurt. It's real sometimes. Ain't no doubt about it.
Yeah, it's fake. Yeah, some parts of it is. 90% of it is.
I believe about 80% of it's fake and about 20% of it's real because sometimes I do get carried away.
For those who believe, no explanation is necessary. And for those who don't, none is good enough.
I guess you'll have to draw your own conclusion about how authentic pro wrestling really is. But one thing's for sure, those pro wrestlers really put on one heck of a show. Now don't go away, PM Magazine departments are coming up next.